According to new research, women who have sex so frequently that it may cause them some problems, sometimes referred to as being hypersexual, seem to be characterized more by their high rates of masturbation and pornography use rather than passive forms of sexual behavior like fantasies and whatever, stuff like that. So hypersexuality, if you're not totally sure what that means, it's a really highly debated topic among psychiatrists and sexual medicine researchers because they can't all agree on how much is too much. So what makes somebody hypersexual and what makes somebody else just really like sex? To classify it as a disorder. But perhaps more controversial are the views on hypersexuality in women because that's never studied. Because nobody cares, apparently. Well, they care now. So researchers conducted a study. The results showed that the more frequently women masturbated or watched porn, the more likely they were to score high on the hypersexuality questionnaire. A higher number of sexual partners was also linked with the hypersexuality scores, according to the study, which was published in the Journal of Sexual Medicine in June. The results of the current study do not support the idea of previous research that hypersexual women are typically engaged in more passive forms of sexual behavior and contradict the assumption that hypersexual women only use sexual behavior to control and influence interpersonal relationships. So it seems like they're trying. I give them points on at least researching the topic, but it doesn't sound like they've really figured out exactly what it means
yet. What I loved about this story was that prior to this study, they thought that women express their hypersexuality through fantasies and through passive behavior, right? And now all of a sudden they're like, oh, would you look at that? If women are hypersexual, it turns out that they masturbate and they have multiple partners. We thought that only men did that.
What year is this?
So it kind of feels like they had like certain gender expectations, biased them in their previous research. Although, as Gina mentioned, previously they didn't do a lot of research into women. They focused more on men. Whenever the issue of sex addiction comes up, they focus primarily on men as if women aren't, you know, experiencing similar hypersexual tendencies.
Right.
Yeah, and I don't know what the breakdown is of people who are sex addicts, men or women. I imagine that it's a lot more men, but it can't be no women.
Four
female sex addicts. Yeah.
Well, but that's the thing. Like, how crazy is it that we're just getting around to looking into this?
Yeah. There's a lot of disagreement about whether or not sex addiction is real. What is sex addiction? Right. How do you define it? I mean, I'm obviously not a researcher or a healthcare professional or anything, but to me, a sex addict is someone who has so much sex that it interferes with their life. Like, they're not able to go to work, they're not able to develop personal relationships, they're just focused on having sex, masturbating, watching porn, that's it. But since there's so much disagreement, the latest version of the DSM, the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, hasn't even included sex addiction. So there still needs to be a lot of studies done in this area. My gestures for this story, just very weird. But it is fascinating to see that, you know, women are just as impacted by this problem as men are.
That is interesting. I have no doubt that whether it's included in the DSM and there's debate about it. I don't know why, but I don't have a moment's hesitation that it's a real thing. That people, the way...
It's a compulsion.
Whether you're a gambling addict or whether it's, you know, putting a substance into you like alcohol or drugs or heroin, something like that. But there are legitimate eating disorders, and there are, you know, it's tough with eating and sex because they are things
you're going to do anyway.
Right, that you're going to do anyway. So it is trickier for people to sort of wrap their arms around. But the bottom line is compulsion is compulsion.
Exactly.
And it is a kind of compulsion that can wreck your life.
Yeah. And I think it's exactly what Anna said. And I think that is the definition of addiction is when does it interfere with your day-to-day life.
Exactly.
And I think it might not be that simple, but I think that's pretty much what that means.
Yeah.
So hypersexuality, you know, just because a woman has a pair of handcuffs and whatever in her boudoir drawer does not make her hypersexual.
No one's judging you,
Joe. I was trying to be sexy. Did it not work?